Okay, so let me go ahead and share my screen. Okay, you see my screen? Okay.
Yes.
Yep.
All right, so there's a couple scenarios we're going to go through here on our way to a paperless office. The first is going to be, I think, something that's happened with pretty much every business right now that has shut down. And that's, how are you collecting and distributing the mail that's coming into your office every day? A lot of businesses have an employee that's going into the office on a regular basis to pick up the mail, but then how do they get it to the person that it needs to go to? So we're going to show you a couple tools here that are attached to our DocuWare content management system that will allow us to be able to capture hard copy documents, upload them into DocuWare, and then categorize them and distribute them to whoever they need to go to. The first thing I'm going to show you is with hard copy email. We've got a I've got a piece of paper here that I'm going to go ahead and scan that looks like mail, and you should be able to see that on my desktop right now. So using the DocuWare paper scan application, I capture a document. And now I'm going to upload that document into a tray in our DocuWare system. I'm on my iPad right now, but there's also an Android version of these applications as well that will allow you to perform the same kind of functionality. So right now I've gone from the PaperScan app into the DocuWare desktop, DocuWare mobile app, and I'm going to select the tray that I want to store this document in. I'm going to put it in a tray called Web Demo. And now you can see that that document's being uploaded into the tray, pardon me, on my iPad. So I'm going to switch from the iPad now and go into my browser. And you can see that I'm logged into our DocuWare system in my Chrome browser. And DocuWare is browser agnostic, so whatever your preferred browser is, you can use either one you want. And I can see that I've got a couple of documents in here. Here's the one I just scanned up. And I'm going to open that up. And this is actually an image of that document that I just took with my iPad. Now I need to put this, store this permanently in the DocuWare system, and I'm going to assign it to a specific individual for them to be able to utilize or to review and approve. So I click the store button in my DocuWare. I can go ahead and add some specific information. I can put a topic in here if I want. But most importantly, I want to assign this to an individual user in our system. And the way that we have this set up and the way that DocuWare functions is it has a search while you type capability. And this particular assigned to field is connected directly to all the users in our DocuWare system. I'm going to elect to send this to the admin user. The status, as you can see, is set to new automatically, and that status field is going to become very important a little ways down the road. I also have a document type, so I can identify what type of document this is. I'm going to select field ticket, and then I'm going to store the document. You can see now that that document has been pulled out of my tray and has been stored into DocuWare permanently. I'm currently logged in as myself in this particular browser. I'm going to jump over to another browser where I'm logged in as the admin user. So you can see the name up here has changed to system admin. I've logged in as a different user. One of the other options in DocuWare is that you can create lists that will give you a filtered view of content that's been stored in the DocuWare system. And I have this list set up so that it's going to show this particular user only the documents that have been assigned to them. As you can see in this assign field, that's true for all these items. Here's the field ticket document that we just scanned up, captured with our iPad a little bit earlier. Mm-hmm. Now I want to go ahead as admin and review this document and then either approve it or disapprove it. So if I double click on the document record itself, it opens up the document in the system. And I can go through and read this, look at the fields that are attached to the document, and I'm going to go ahead and approve this document. And the way we're going to do that within DocuWare is utilizing the stamp capability that DocuWare has. I'm going to select my approved stamp. And once I do that, you can see that it automatically adds my name, a date, time, and then also some text that's totally customizable to this particular document. Now, I want you to watch carefully as I solidify this saving of the stamp. And notice now that I only have two items left in my new list. So what's happened is, by virtue of approving that document with the stamp, I've not only approved it and put a visible stamp on it, but it's also changed the status of the document so it no longer qualifies for this particular view within the system. So if I go back to my other browser, now I'm back logged in as myself, I'm going to go ahead and do a search in this same storage area for all my documents that have an approved status. If I click search, I can see that there's my field ticket that's now been added into the system and updated with the approved status. If I double click on that, you can see the document pops up and there's my approved stamp.
That's pretty neat.
This is a pretty basic functionality, but I think you can kind of get a sense for the value that this type of system can provide for you in distributing and being able to work with your hard copy documents.
Right. And you mentioned something also about what your service you can.
Second item I'd like to show you is DocuWare's integration with Microsoft Outlook. We also get a lot of content in via our email accounts. And I have an email in here that I sent myself from another email account, and it has a document attached to it. Within Outlook, I can right click on this document, go down to my store in DocuWare, and I'm going to pick my web demo store. And next, what's going to happen is the pop-up for that store dialog is going to ask me some questions about how I want to store this document and what exactly do I want to store. So again, notice that some of the fields have automatically been populated here based off the fact that this was an email that was sent. So I've captured the subject line from the email, I've captured the sender's email address. I can go in and add a company in here. And again, search while you type. I can then assign this to another user. I'm going to assign it to the admin user again. The status and the document type and the date are automatically sent. And then the last thing I want to do is I want to save both the email and the attachment, but I want the attachment to show up first in the DocuWare record. Once I've completed all this, again, I hit my store button. And notice the blue flag that's now attached to this email, which notifies me that this document has already been stored in DocuWare. So I know to not do it again. I could also change the functionality there where the email could actually be deleted from my Outlook altogether if I wanted, so that it wouldn't be cluttering up my inbox. I'm going to go ahead and go back to the admin login user within the DocuWare system. And notice I now have another new document in my list that's marked as new, and it came in as an email document type. There's my email address and all the information that was put in during the store process. So I open up this document, and I see that this document is not something that I'm able to approve. So I need to forward it on or assign it to another user. So if I go ahead and close this, and then I right click on this document and go to send request. So what I'm going to show you is basically a real quick and simple workflow that can be used to create a task in the DocuWare system and assign this document to a new user. So in the search box, I've typed in my name, which again has then filtered the set of users. I pick my user that I want to assign it to. And then I'm going to add some text down here. And let me grab that text quickly. So above my pay grade, I have the decisions that the user can make that it's been assigned to them, and the user that's going to get it, and the text that's going to show up. I now hit send request. And now what's going to happen is in my email box, I will get a new email from DocuWare, and here it is. It states, please approve this document above my pay grade. Remember, that was the text that I typed in the comments. and I've got a link directly to that document. So I can double click on that link. It takes me right to the document as well as the little workflow task that's been assigned to me. I can either approve or decline this. I'm going to go ahead and approve it and add some comments. And then confirm this. So now that task has been completed and the document is out of my task list. If I go back to my other email account, I can see that DocuWare has sent me, now being admin, a new email that says all the users have been completed the request. And there's again the text detail of the request itself. If I click on that email, now being logged in as the admin, I can see here are the steps that were performed first by myself as admin, where I assigned this document to the new user, and then the decision that was made by that user to approve the document. So those are just a couple of the things that DocuWare has the capability to do for you to give you some immediate relief from a content management standpoint to be able to manage your hard copy as well as any of your already digital documents. Does anybody have any questions?
Pretty impressive. So when you were doing those stamps, can you create your own user stamps for the approved?
You just came back online, Art, so I missed most of that.
Oh, I'm sorry. So with the user stamps.
Yep.
Can they be customized?
Absolutely.
Okay.
You can actually put drop-down lists in a stamp. So for example, we're setting up a very simple AP approval process for Eastern Auto Parts Warehouse in Levittown area. And because they have no real hard and fast rules about who, what type of vendor invoice may need a second approval, what we did for them is we built a drop-down list of the approval capable users. And when the first user goes and does the initial approval on a document, if based on some very difficult to understand criteria, they need to have it approved at the next level, they can select that user. That user not only gets put into the stamp, but it also assigns the document to that user at the same time and updates the status. So the stamps are very powerful. They can be used to trigger workflows. They can be involved within workflows, the whole nine yards.
This would be a great process for sales orders too, because salesmen or people who are selling could actually get notifications once the document's been looked at and then forwarded to order entry.
Yep.
I like the part too about being able to take any document in Outlook and then moving it to DocuWare also.
Exactly.
That can save a tremendous amount of time.
Right. Well, let's face it, most people, I would imagine nowadays, their inbound email attachments is probably the principal way they get content that they need to work with. So yeah. Having that integration, and I can show you if you go back to DocuWare, in this DocuWare menu choice, if I go down and do a quick search and do web demo, this actually interfaces directly with DocuWare. So you remember that list I had of new items?
Yes.
These are the new items that are assigned to me. And I can actually work on these right from Outlook. I don't even have to be in DocuWare. So I can open this document up. And it'll open up another browser instance. I can go ahead and do whatever I need to do to it. Let's say I'm going to stamp it as acknowledged. And I put the acknowledged stamp on it. See, it's taken it out of my new list. And it's automatically now changed the status of the document. So if I go back to search. And let's go acknowledged. there's that document I just stamped acknowledged. So the status field, the two key things you always want to have in a content management system is a status field and a document type field, because those are the two most common fields or pieces of information that you use to drive process and drive workflow and all that sort of thing. Very important.
Yeah, cool. It seems pretty simple too. Rick, thanks. I appreciate it. I appreciate the taking the time to do this.
No problem. Happy to help.